In problem set number 5, you will be designing and implementing a fast parallel algorithm to compute histograms. You already implemented a kernel for computing histograms in problem set number 3 that used atomic operations. However, it turns out that we can get much better performance if we avoid atomic operations altogether. And that is our goal in problem set number 5. There are a lot of different ways to efficiently compute histograms. We strongly encourage you to experiment and test out different ideas. But one basic strategy that works well is as follows. First, sort the input data into coarse bins. 2, use each thread block to compute a local histogram for the data that falls into a single coarse bin. 3, concatenate each of the coarse histograms together. This strategy is advantageous because each local histogram will have a small number of bins, so it will be able to fit into shared memory. This is true regardless of how many bins the final histogram has. Let's look at a simple example to see how this strategy will work. Suppose our input data is in the range of 0 to 999, and suppose we want to bin our input data into 100 different equally sized histogram bins. And here's our data. As you can see, it ranges from 0 to 999. And now let's compute the bin ID for each input element, as well as a coarse bin ID for each input element. So let's suppose we have 10 equally sized coarse bins. And this is the result of calculating the bin ID as well as the coarse bin ID for each of the input element. And now let's sort the final bin ID by the coarse bin ID, and let's see what we have. And this is the final result after we sort the bin ID by its coarse bin ID. Now let's assign a thread block to each coarse bin. So thread block 0 is responsible for computing the histogram of coarse bin ID 0. Thread block 1 won't have anything to do because in the sorted coarse bin ID, there is not a bin with an ID of 1, so it will compute an empty histogram. Thread block 2 will compute the histogram of coarse bin ID of 2, and so on. And to get our final histogram, we can simply concatenate all those histograms together end to end. So we would combine the histogram that we calculated for coarse bin ID of 1 with the histogram that we computed for coarse bin ID of 2, and so on and so forth. And that's it. Good luck.